I am in the Mercedes-Benz booth here at CES 2018, and they're showcasing their Mercedes-Benz user experience. And, you know, I got to tell you, user experience is really the next generation of what the cars are going to be about. And, of course, they're going to be electric. And autonomous driving, of course, is part of that user experience. Now, as we know, a lot of, you know, German manufacturers have been maybe a little bit of hesitant to go electric car route, but a lot of them have committed, including Mercedes-Benz, to electrifying their fleets in the next 5 years or so. So Mercedes-Benz is presenting one of their concept cars, EQA concept, and also they have their supercar concept, Project One, that they're here. There's a huge theater behind me where they're showing a lot of different demos and examples of what it's going to be like to drive a Mercedes-Benz just in the next few years.
Yeah, we see different opportunities with a higher level of automation. The key fact will be that people can use the time where they don't want to drive because it's boring in a traffic jam or for whatever reason. They can use the time to do better things than just sitting there and waiting until the trip is gone. They can make side activities. They can read emails. They can do their stuff like they had done in the office. And once they are at home, they are done with work.
And we will introduce up from now to 2022 more than 10 electric vehicles on the same platform. So what you can expect is from the size of an A-Class up to the size of an S-Class, and from the smallest SUV to the biggest SUV, we will electrify everything. This starts with electric drive, but this goes further on with the four letters. You know, we call it CASE. It will be connected, it will be autonomous, it will be share, and it will be electric. This is all four together. We'll build a new ecosystem where the customer will get everything he needs for future mobility.
And talking about that, you know, when you have an electric car, you got to charge it somewhere. And most people will probably charge it at home. But, you know, for long distance trips and so forth, a lot of people will need charging stations, which is, you know, a challenge right now. You know, Tesla has their own supercharging network. Where do you see that go? Where do you see your customers charging your car when they're traveling?
What we intend to do is to standardize the infrastructure and use it for every car. If it's an European car, an American car, or a Japanese car, we are aiming for not to have the same situation as you have it with the smartphones.
Please don't.
Yeah. And that's the overall game we play for. And what we're aiming for is we will start with DC charging, beginning above 100 kilowatt, which enables such a car like this or an EQC to recharge it below 30 minutes if it's empty on a long distance trip. And we aim additionally for a so-called high performance charging system, which will have 350 kilowatt performance. This means with a battery round about 100 kilowatt hours, you will get a recharge from 10% to 80% in a time round about 15 minutes. That's the overall aim we are focused on. And this will enable the customers to use electric vehicles as they are used to use their combustion engine vehicles.
Well, I'm cautiously optimistic. I mean, obviously, these are not exactly the answers I wanted to hear. I don't think they still have figured out what the charging network is going to be for long distance traveling, and you can hear it in their answers, but at least they're working on it, you know. And I don't want to give them brownie points just for kind of saying things. It does look like they're moving in the right direction and investing money into the electrifying their fleet. So let's see what happens. I'm definitely excited that they are here and they're presenting this, you know, what I hope will be amazing cars. All right, I will keep my eye on this. Other than that, I will see you guys next time, and remember to stay charged.